Hi, welcome to the University of Arizona. Today we're doing the Tucson Festival of Books, but here at the Student Union we have this masthead of art from the USS Tucson, and it just dawned on me that all those little tags are the dog tags of those who passed. Hi, I'm the lone journalist for KRAZ-TV. We'll be right back as we show you our 2022 Tucson Festival of Books. More public art here at the University of Arizona, brought to you by KRAZ-TV. So we're here at Student Union. We're going to be taking a walk through into the mall and see where we go from there.
Broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets bright glare, the bombs burst.
Officially opens the Tucson Festival of Books here at 2022. I'm the lone journalist. We'll go on from here. AmeriCorps serving here. So it's Friends of the Festival. So they're playing band music here. KRAZ-TV roaming amongst the tents here already at the March the 12th. There's Amigos and Ladies of the West. We had an interview with her several years ago. Hi, and you are?
Pamela Tracy.
There she is, best-selling romance author, Meet USA Today. Well, here she is. Show us what you have here at the Tucson Festival of Books.
Hello, audience. I'm Pamela Tracy, and I have been writing since about 1996. My first book came out in 1999. I primarily write romances with a face-bathed element. But you can find cowboys, you can find dogs, you can find suspense, you can find historical. But here are my books. I write for about four different publishers, and I've been doing it for a long time. Next to me is my best friend, Kathy McDavid, who kind of followed the same career path.
This is her?
Yep, that's Kathy McDavid, and she writes a number of books, cowboys,
and all kinds
of things like that.
Well, we're KRAZ-TV. It means keep real, A to Z, true vision. And this is truly a wonderful thing, and I'm glad it came back this year.
We're so happy to have it back. I can't
so you have cowboys, sweethearts, and romances.
Yep. Thank you so much.
Well, thank you very much. And from the Tucson Festival of Books 2022, thank you again from KRAZ-TV. Bye.
Bye.
We want to thank Pamela Tracy, USA Today's best-selling romance author. We had a little interview with her, and well, she started early. So start early and come down here to the Tucson Book Festival of Books 2022. Well, we came across this little crossword puzzle here at the Tucson Festival of Books 2022. So these are some of the clues. Up and down, and then here's the actual, well, crossword itself. Literary locales, locals, Locales. Carrie Z TV. Well, there's book signing, U of A books, stages. Oh, this is a great, great festival of books this year, 2022. So I hope my friend Francisco Rivera, he's one of Arizona's newest Hispanic writers here in Southern Arizona, and he went to the University of Arizona. I'm going to give him a call and see if he'll come down, and I have a gift for him.
I name of cats, horses, and dogs, but I also talk to wild animals.
Good for you.
And I'm an intuitive medium, so I talk to people on the other side. I find a lot of people that wouldn't call up a medium will call up an animal communicator and talk to their animals on the other side, and then their loved ones on the other side that are people come through too.
That's wonderful.
And so it's all a big circle of love.
It is a circle of love. Well, we're here with Anna Marie Hoff, artist, pet communicator, intuitive medium, and a published author.
Yes.
This is her book, Animal Lover. I have her card. I'm going to put her on, and she gets joint rights for this. So if you just download it and use it like you want.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, and thank you for letting KRAC TV do a little interview with you.
You're welcome. Have a great day.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Well, we're here at Arizona Litho, and these fine folks, they're in here with a great presentation. But we're going to show all the show here. So from Arizona Litho, this is KRAC TV saying, come to the 2022 Tucson Festival of Books and stop here at Arizona Litho. Well, the Tucson Police has a therapy dog here. She's a Maggie's her name. Such a sweet little baby animal. So she's playing with everybody down here at the book festival. And here's more pets. We've seen him before. Oh, Grace Lutheran, Friends of PM Press. Friends of the Pima County Public Library, more boxers, Reading Glass Books, Bookmark Alliance. So we're gonna go through here and show a lot of these people here. But mostly I'll make a slideshow, so we won't bore you with my speaking a lot, but thanks for watching.
It's not your responsibility to make others happy. It is your responsibility to put on paper what you are thinking, what is in your heart, what you believe in, and then
here at the food court.
It is not your responsibility to make me happy or your parents happy.
Well, KRAZ TV has come across another crossword puzzle. Well, this one is Dance at a Glance. So it's all about music, prop names, shadow dance, Fred Astaire's, choreography, music singers, Father of American Ballet, all of these great little clues to this one wonderful dance at a glance here at Tucson Festival of Books, KRAZ TV, the lone journalist. New Mexico Book Association, serving all book professionals. A GPD Toy Train Museum. Oh, Toy Train.
Imagine building the whole state of Arizona and having a train run through it.
You know, the museum.
I'll check it out.
Okay.
Cross your fingers.
That would be good. I had one of these in 1956.
Oh, nice.
Gadsden Pacific Toy Train Operating Museum. That's you guys. And we're here at the Tucson Book Festival. And doesn't this bring back nostalgia? Sure does. Maybe I ought to get their card and go see if they have a museum I can go through. I want to thank the Gadsden Pacific Toy Train Operating Museum, and they've invited me to come down to Miller Road and take a look at it, and I'll do a interview and everything down there and show it to you. So it must be 11 o'clock or 10. The flavor of the show. Nothing but wonderfulness here in 2022. Well, the lone journalist here at the Tucson Festival of Books has just been notified by an author that he's on his way. So we're going to have an interview with an Arizona author who went to the university here, and he's actually published 3 books. So he'll be at the, we'll be at the USS War Memorial here on the Mall of the USS Arizona, and we'll have an interview there. So from the show, this is the Book Festival. Well, here we are at Arizona State Poetry Society, and we have Nana Posey. Hi.
Hello. So for you little poets out there and big poets, I have a poetry journal for kids.
Wonderful.
No rules. Lines for you to write what's on your heart.
Oh, great idea.
Yes, because one of you might write the next best poetry form ever, right?
Well, I hope so.
I also write children's books.
Are you here?
Books.
Where are you from?
I am from Scottsdale, Arizona.
Oh, you're from ASU? Is this Arizona State?
No.
$1 raffle for...
Oh, but Arizona State Poetry Society has members from all over the state.
This is very
but
convenient.
This little book just made Amazon's hot new releases number one for one day.
Well, how wonderful.
But it's the fourth in a series that I'm just unpacking. But
well, how wonderful.
Nana Posey's this cantankerous grandma who wants the wildlife in her backyard to behave how she thinks they should.
Oh.
And they never do. So she has some disagreements with the quail, the mockingbird, the... Anyway, so...
Well, you're Linda Rittenhouse.
Yes.
Well, I thought your name was Nana Posey,
well,
but you can be that person.
My grand.
Well, she is.
My grandkids started calling me that, Nana Posey.
There you go.
There you go.
She's Nana Posey.
Yeah, there is a reason for all that. Yeah. I live in an imaginary world myself.
And I'm just a tree frog. And that's my book there. It's,
how wonderful.
If you want to learn about haiku, this is a great book for
haiku is wonderful. I went to Costa Rica and saw those. Under
the tree frogs? Oh, yeah, they're awesome.
Well, it was black and yellow, but...
Oh, yeah, there's
but
different
But the guy was just walking through the jungle, and he just pushed some leaves, and there it was.
Mm-hmm.
So, Linda is... What other books has she got?
Linda started out writing... I used to coach basketball, fast pitch, boys, girls, track for 20 years. This is based on my experiences coaching track, which is... and long jump especially. So this kid who thinks all the other kids have a perfect life except him can't wait for track season because he's finally going to get to be the best at something because he's really fast. So he shows up to the gym on the first day of practice and he goes, what are my friends doing lining up on the baseline facing the French teacher? And he's so upset that, like, how is this possible? But, so it's a story of Noah Martin and his, it's kind of a coming of age. There is poetry in this book.
Uh-huh.
There is, I hope it inspires young
people. Well, I think it does, but I think you inspire a lot of people, too. You are Arizona true treasure.
Thank you,
Linda, and watch KRZ-TV. And by the way, you own joint rights to this video, so when you see it, download it, and you
okay.
Own it.
Thank
you.
Bye.
So all right, well, she's getting set up.
But
thank you, Linda.
Thank you.
Nana Posey. Bye.
Adios.
Wasn't that just sweet as can be? And she's a real motivation here in Arizona. So I'm so happy to have met some of these authors, publishers, artists, first aid and medical. So here, the Dyslexic Handbook, Cussing for Kids, Etiquette for the Profane. Cosworth Publishing. Well, this is Cosworth Publishing?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, well, thank you. Well, I'm here at I'm KRAZ-TV, and I'm showing everything of the show, so I don't want to bother you when you have customers. So we're going to let him take a look at everything, but he is showing me some of the adult sections here. He has children's books. He calls some of them silly, but some of these subjects are not silly, and these are not silly books.
No, those are not.
Those are not.
We have a number on chronic pain, one on suicide, a series of historical fiction on the Jack the Ripper story, and some filmmaking books.
Well, how wonderful. Well, we're making a film now, and you get to watch it, and you get to download it. You own this little clip for yourself, joint rights.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, and from Cosworth Publishing, this is The Lone Journalist. Well, we're about halfway down on one side, and there is the Flandreau Planetarium. They have a new thing called Wild World of Bugs. So, we're getting ready to... Well, I can't believe it. Somebody wants to interview me, so I'm going to talk about my mother's books and thank a publishing company and all. So stay tuned to KRAZ-TV and come down to the 2022 Tucson Festival of Books. Well, I want to thank Zen Bones Productions, but we're also here at this little circus. So this is the Lindley Lopez Circus, and it's down here at the Book Festival. So we've got K-Gun 9 News, food trucks, services, institutions, nonprofits, vendors, everything and everybody in between. So here's Harper Collins, Child Books, and the little girls here getting ready for their show. Well, we'd like to thank Jonathan and Roseanne Hansen for... the little story that they have, and they've done everything. They're from local here in Arizona, and they have nice books about the San Pedro River. So we're going to see y'all later. Bye. Ameren Museum. So we're gonna get on down here because Francisco will be coming soon. Published authors. Well, we wanna thank White Bear. Hopi Art. She knew Johnny Martin. She told me, though, she said, I didn't know his white man's name at Johnny Martin. I knew him as Erki Kimu. So, how about that for things? So I'm going to head on down here, see if Francisco's here. Hi, I'm the Lone Journalist for KRAZ-TV here at the USS Arizona Mall Memorial for the USS Arizona. So this is, a tragic day that started World War II. But anyways, we're here to have an interview with Francisco Rivera, who happened to be on the color guard when he was stationed in Hawaii for the USS Arizona. So we're eagerly awaiting him, and we're going to have an interview with his books. And here are some of the people who passed that day.
And I grew up there for about 20 years. They brought me when I was just a tiny.
Nice. Okay.
After this, I was avoiding the draft because
sure.
I didn't want to go to Vietnam.
Right, good
but
job.
But I still served.
Yeah.
So I enrolled at the community college next door simply for student deferment purposes, to keep the draft at bay.
Yeah.
And then when the time came, I went overseas with the Navy for 2 years. And I returned to Arizona to the U of A. And that's the third part of the trilogy, the college years, the U of A. And I matriculated from here to the master's degree. And I settled in Tucson. I've been in Tucson ever since.
Oh, lovely. Well, thank you. I'll remember that. Thank you.
And when he was in Hawaii, he was on the color guard for the USS Arizona.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
When he served.
Wow.
It was a very interesting voyage.
This must be a nonfiction then, is it?
Nonfiction.
Nonfiction, okay, good.
It might be a little bit hard because I'm bilingual, bicultural.
Uh-huh.
So it has a lot of Spanish in it.
Spanglish, too.
I published it. I'm the publisher.
No, this is my friend, Pepe
Joe so I helped him,
Dominguez.
He had decipher a lot,
he contributed tremendously to the book.
Okay.
Being my mentor, my guide, director, publisher. And this is Reed, a real good friend, a Navy man himself. We're a trilogy also. 1, 2, 3.
Trilogy. Well, we're going to go over here and talk some more about his book, but thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Have a good weekend.
Yeah, thank you.
And this is our final parting shot. with an author, Francisco A. Rivera, admiring and reading the story of the Belle from the USS Arizona. Thanks a lot, Francisco. I'm here with you and we're together on this 2022.
Thank you, Reed, for helping us, for keeping the memory alive, and for assisting the Tucson Book Festival.
And promoting his books. He's written three of them now.
Three.
And show us the big one before we go out of here. There it is, An Odyssey by Farr, and that is Farr yourself, Francisco A. Rivera. Thank you.
It's a trilogy. You're welcome to read it and enjoy it. Thank you very much.
Goodbye.